We know for some of our little kids that potentially school is going to be a little bit more of a struggle. Usually, though, in some very finite areas, they may have a little bit of extra trouble with reading, and so they need some maybe a different way to learn how to read or a little bit of extra help with reading. It's not going to really vastly kind of affect what their capabilities are going to be or where they're going to end up in life. They lose strength during therapy, so strength and rebuilding muscle tone and getting back all their joint health is sometimes a struggle for them. And so I think physical therapy and activities, and for the young ones playing, for the older ones, you know, getting outside of the house are certainly really important. Kids may have some late effects. But we really are in a time and age where we can minimize a lot of those. For our little ones, a lot of their fertility is going to be preserved. For our teenagers and young adults, as they come to us, we can certainly talk about some fertility saving options, particularly for the boys, prior to starting chemotherapy. There can be some early joint problems, and that's also something we watch for. And some older patients particularly will have to face earlier joint replacements than kids who did not have leukemia as they're growing up. Our agents can be hard on the heart muscle, particularly the therapy for acute myeloid leukemia. So we monitor pretty carefully, have our cardiologists help us if we have any concerns, and really try to jump on any side effects from the heart or kidneys or liver early on, so that again we can ultimately protect the best function of those organs as we can.